My head is gonna explode.
Margie said the headaches were just pounding.
I took aspirin for the pain. Didn't help me at all.
As the headaches were getting worse, her vision slowly started to get blurry on her. She would have a hard time focusing.
It was a little bit scary. Jeff tried to get me to go to the doctor. I finally did. They told me I had high blood pressure and that it was causing lesions in the back of my eyes.
Left again?
Started taking high blood pressure medicine. I felt like it was all gonna get better. I just felt like I had an answer.
But 2 weeks after, there was no sign of any improvement.
The headaches were getting more intense.
The pain more or less took over. She'd be in tears.
Mommy, 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 let's read a book.
And my vision was getting blurrier. I could make out who my kids were just from their voice, color of their hair.
Alyssa, Aaron.
Jeff was so worried about her condition that he decided to take Margie to casualty.
They ran a couple tests.
Margie, I'm afraid the news isn't good. It's glaucoma.
Worst case scenario was her going blind.
I'm very sorry, Margie.
Blind, I mean, how do you deal with that? They gave her some medication. They were just looking to keep an eye on her, monitor her.
But the next day, her condition took a turn for the worse.
I knew something was really wrong.
Hello?
She goes, Mom, come over.
I'll be right there.
When I got there, she looked very sick. We just immediately went to the doctor.
Hi, how can I help you?
We called my daughter Margie.
They took her right back to the examining room.
I really was totally out of it. It's all kind of a blur.
The nurse came out and she said, the doctor needs to talk to you right away.
What's wrong with my daughter?
Your daughter's pregnant.
Pregnant? She's not pregnant. How can that be?
I'm looking at him wide-eyed like, what is this guy talking about? He told me that her whole body was poisoned. And I asked him, how could that happen? And he said, it's toxemia. From the pregnancy.
Toxemia, which is another word for preeclampsia, is potentially very dangerous, especially with the elevated blood pressure. It can be associated with stroke, heart attack, and especially problems with the unborn child.
She has to have an emergency C-section.
Thought of losing my child. I started to feel grief. But I got a hold of myself and told myself my job was to help my daughter and her family. So I said, well, can the children at least come back and give their mommy a kiss?
All right, just make it really fast.
Alyssa and Aaron may not see their mother alive again.
Let's kiss her goodbye.
It was a very sad thought, and I'm acting like everything is fine.
Mommy's gonna go have a baby.
They didn't know if either one of them would survive. I was terrified.
Toxemia could lead to kidney failure. It can cause rupture of the liver, which can cause a severe internal hemorrhage, and in some circumstances, death.
Doctors performed an emergency cesarean section and delivered a premature baby boy who weighed just under 2 kilograms. They immediately transferred him to the neonatal intensive care unit.
Getting a hold of Jeff was a major challenge.
Margie's mum, Darlene, left a message for Jeff at work. He raced across town without knowing why his wife had been admitted to the hospital.
When I get to the hospital, I ask for my wife. And I tell the lady who I was.
Oh, congratulations.
And she goes, congratulations, you're a father. I said, no.
You're Jeff, right?
And I was in total disbelief. They took me upstairs, and I met up with the doctor.
The doctor said that they had delivered the baby, but they both were in critical condition.
They were both close to death. didn't know exactly what to think. I mean, I go to the hospital, I find out I'm a father. Then I'm finding out, well, there's a possibility that she could die and the baby could die. I was pretty scared.
He's so tiny.
He was about 6-7 weeks early. He was just right about 4 pounds. I couldn't get over on how small he was. It almost seemed like he was able to fit in the palm of your hand. He just had all these wires and tubes running out of him.
We were able to go in and see her. Margie was unconscious. They were running medicines through her body.
Doctors advised the family that Margie's chances of a complete recovery were slim. Then, after 48 hours, Margie defied the odds.
The anesthesiologist actually told me that he'd never seen anybody as bad as I did come out of it before. My headaches were pretty much gone. My vision came back.
I was excited and relieved. Then at that point in time, we were wondering what kind of recovery the baby would have.
The first time I saw him, I immediately fell in love with him. He looked like a frail little thing. He was really small, really skinny, and not like any baby I'd ever had before.
Prematurity is associated with a whole host of problems, from low birth weight to visual problems to failure to grow and failure to thrive.
It was scary. One of the main things I felt guilty about was not getting any prenatal care. I would have taken all my vitamins, you know, eaten healthy, done everything the way I should have done. I guess I just tried thinking good thoughts and hoped for the best and treated him, you know, like he was normal, and which he is, pretty much. His health was great as a child. Hardly ever got sick. We named him Alex Mitchell. Looking back, I got pregnant in September of 95. I think the pill may have failed.
Birth control pills are quite effective when used properly. The problem is that it's somewhat difficult to use them properly. And so if a pill is forgotten for 1 or 2 or 3 days at a specific point in the woman's cycle, she may actually ovulate and get pregnant.